Mr. Kelly?
Yeah.
We saw this fight on TV, and this one guy, he did this move. I was wondering if you could show it to us.
Yeah. Yeah, sure.
When your neck is inside this triangle right here, when I apply pressure, it's actually going to collapse the carotid artery. It restricts the blood flow to the brain, and your training partner is going to either have to ask you to stop or he's going to go unconscious. So now just get your hand ready, and when you feel it, you tap, okay?
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. You okay?
Yeah. Can't you cause brain damage?
No, I mean, only if you hold the choke well after your training partner goes to sleep, but we're gentlemen. I mean, we don't act like that.
It's horrible.
Belly down's even worse. So you hide his hands underneath. Now your training partner doesn't even have the opportunity to tap. It's not the nicest thing in the world to do, but
I'll have to remember that next time I find myself with a dude between my legs. Josh, what are you doing?
Thinking about learning how to grapple. I mean, all the MMA guys use some form of it, at least the guys who win.
Their rules favor ground fighters. Many techniques not allowed in MMA, like bites, eye gouges. Easily stop a grappling attack.
Listen to me, he just asked me to show him a position. I meant no disrespect.
And I don't know why you keep wasting your time with the gay wrestling shit.
Guys, let's get out of
here. What I'm teaching keeps them on their feet and their opponents on the floor.
I know, I understand.
Yeah, but what if someone surprises you from behind, takes you down?
Well, Josh, it depends on the type of attack. If he tries from the back, I've elbows to the face. Or if he tries to tackle me from the front, I drop elbows right on his spine, or I could box his ears, whatever.
Yeah, that would, that would probably hurt.
Oh. You don't think it'd get you off me?
I didn't say that.
Huh?
Jimmy.
Old man, why don't we try it? Hmm? Why don't we try it? Come on.
You're gonna stand there and you're gonna tell my students that my techniques don't work? Glove up and prove it.
I'm not telling your students anything, Jimmy. Okay?
Hey, no one has to get hurt. As soon as you're ready to stop, just, you know, tap out. You're used to that, right?
Gentlemen, it's time to go. I got a lot of cleaning to do before class tomorrow. Let's go.
Come on, Mick.
Now.
Come on. Joke.
Let's go, guys.
Come on, Mick. Were you afraid of a little demonstration?
I'll see you tomorrow.
What are you doing?
You want to know what I teach? I'll show you what I teach. You want to know why I think what you teach is garbage? I'll show you that, too. Hell, I'll even give you a roadmap as to what's going to happen. I'm going to close the distance to clinch without so much taking a scratch. I'm going to take you to the ground. I'm going to mount you. I'm going to turn you over, take your back, and I'm going to choke you unconscious. And then just so you don't think it was a fluke, we're going to do it all over again. And I'm going to do the exact same thing in the exact same order. And there's not a goddamn thing you can do about it.
Okay. You just know if you get too close, I'm throwing for real.
What is going on?
I'm throwing with bad intentions.
Okay, pal.
Let's rock.